to send us off. This is the Spectrum Trio, and we are about to take off early next week to Las Palmas in the Canary Islands for the World Saxophone Congress, which occurs every 3 years and is a selective, peer-reviewed conference. So we're very fortunate that our two pieces tonight are being premiered there. We're very fortunate at Susquehanna to have a very robust composition community led by Dr. Patrick Long, and equally fortunate to have a piece written by Dr. Long and President Green. The first piece we're going to play today is by President Green, called Trio Rundi. And for those who don't know what Rundi is, it is a very large bamboo plant, which is what reeds are made out of. So, Trio Rundi.
Thank you.
things in New York City this weekend. So, so the next piece by Dr. Long is called Trio. It's a three-movement work, truly virtuosic in nature, and on both pieces, but in particular, Dr. Long's piece is going to be an incredible addition to the saxophone chamber music repertoire. Thank you, Dr. Long.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you all so much for coming out this evening. This is the Universal Symphonic Band, and hopefully you've enjoyed that first piece called The Citadel Suite. They've made such wonderful progress, and it's just been a real pleasure making music with these guys this semester. If you came at 7, you were treated to a wonderful concert by the Spectrum Trio, which is made up of our very own Dr. Gail Levinsky on saxophone, Dr. Jamie Damigo on piano, and a guest artist, Dr. Lorraine Dusso, on oboe. I don't think that Dr. Levinsky made a big enough deal of the honor that these conference performances are. There are hundreds of applicants that come in to play at these conferences. You can imagine a whole conference full of saxophone players.
Yeah.
And there she is. These are very competitive things, and so I want to make sure that we give them another round of applause to show our congratulations for the achievement of being asked to come. Shows what a wonderful atmosphere of collaboration we have here, where we have Dr. Long contributing a piece, our very own university president contributing a piece, and that just runs through the department, and we try to instill that collaboration in our students, and you hopefully heard some of that earlier in the week when you heard the chamber music concert. So we want to thank them for their contribution as well. As some of you may know, I got COVID in Arizona, Boo, Arizona. And so I was out of commission for a few days, and there aren't very many places where you can call your university president and ask him to take a rehearsal for you. And so that was wonderful that he would come in and fill in for me last Monday. We were able to pull this next piece, actually the program itself was kind of put together intentionally, in that two of the pieces were written in the 60s, 2 years apart, and the two more modern pieces were written in the same year. I mean, you can sort of hear the breadth of development within the wind band and composition for it. The incidental suite has a lot of work with hemiolas and things like that, rhythmic devices that were important, which would become important in future compositions, whereas the piece we're about to play is based on a Haydn string quartet at the last movement, and we're going to do our best to channel Haydn through this and keep it nice and light and dance-like. Excuse me. Still the lingering effects of and then the Copley is very, very rhythmic and very interesting and dynamic piece, so I hope you enjoy. That's our last piece that we're going to play. But right now we're going to play the Dello Gioia for you, Fantasy on a Theme by Haydn.
Thank you.
thanks to Anna and Rebecca Gibbons. Property manager is Tim Bortner. We have two librarians, Owen Smith and Vinny Checo. And our social media manager is